getting it just one arm?
Both of my arms.
Oh, wow.
For most patients with acute lymphoblastic leukemia, the kind of cancer Bo Cooper suffers from, standard treatment can offer a cure. But Bo is among a very small group whose leukemia has proven incurable.
Back in Canada, Bo received chemotherapy, standard initial treatment for leukemia. He then received a bone marrow transplant. None of those treatments have been able to keep the leukemia away.
Hey, Doc.
How you doing?
Good.
Yeah?
Shake your hand, but there's a needle in there.
Attached. It's kind of hard to move.
With all standard therapies having failed Bo, Dr. Fry and his team will be trying something radical, re-engineering Bo's own immune system to cure his cancer. The first step in that treatment is for Bo's T cells, a type of immune cell, to be removed from his blood in a process called apheresis.
Cells get separated in the machine into the different components. The part that we need goes into a bag, the rest of it goes back into you in the other arm. Does that make sense?
Yeah, sounds good.
Each leukemia cell in Bo's body is marked with different proteins on its surface. Among them, one that is called CD22. Since Bo's immune system doesn't recognize his leukemia as a threat, Dr. Fry will genetically modify one part of it, his T cells, so that they can recognize and attach themselves to the CD22 protein and kill his cancer. This modified T cell is called a chimeric antigen receptor T cell, or CAR T cell for short. It is at the cutting edge of cancer research, and Bo will be the first leukemia patient ever to receive the highest dose of these immune cells.
There's really no other option. Without this working, Bo doesn't survive. This does not work for Bo. He's run out of time.
Finding a cure for cancer patients like Bo Cooper, who do not respond to standard treatment, is the holy grail of medical science and has proven to be one of the most difficult and complicated questions facing humanity. Nearly 40 years ago, right here at Building 10, one man began a personal quest for this elusive cure. Miraculously, he may have found the answer lurking within ourselves.
My voyage in this adventure, if you will, began when I was a junior resident in surgery. And a patient came in, a veteran in his 60s, with right upper quadrant pain. It seemed to be a typical gallbladder attack. But as I went through his chart, an astonishing story evolved. 12 years earlier, he had been operated on for a cancer that had started in his stomach. The surgeons described it having spread to the liver. The patient's abdomen was closed. Nobody expected him to survive. But as I flipped the pages of this chart, he was back in 3 months, feeling okay. 6 months later, he was gaining weight. A year later, he was back at work. And here he was 12 years later, completely cancer-free.
What Dr. Rosenberg witnessed seemed impossible. A person who cured himself of cancer.
Somehow, that patient's body had learned to destroy that cancer, had recognized it as foreign and eliminated it just the way it eliminates a virus from a common cold. It got me thinking that there must be something in that patient's body that caused the regression. And in fact, the immune system is our major defense.
The idea that our own immune system is capable of fighting cancer was so radical that when Dr. Rosenberg began his research, there wasn't even a name for this experimental treatment.
The main problem with your immune system recognizing cancer is that cancer, for the most part, it really is self. It's self gone bad. So how do you tell your immune system that it's bad? That's the tough part.
For a decade, Dr. Rosenburg tried to train the immune system to fight cancer in a number of first-in-human trials. For years, he failed. But in 1985, he successfully cured his first patient with a treatment that has since become known as immunotherapy.
Activating the immune system for cancer treatment, so-called immunotherapy, is the most exciting science in the whole cancer field because it's really working.
Today, immunotherapy is the basis for many of the trials at Building 10, including the one Beau Cooper is enrolled in.
You want to eat?
No.
You hardly ate anything.
In a Building 10 lab, Beau's immune cells are being genetically re-engineered in the hope that they can recognize and fight his cancer.
CAR T cells. That's what we're here for. That's what we want. Waiting's the hardest part.
Beau is scheduled to receive 200 million of these genetically modified immune cells. But the work to create them in the lab is painstaking and can be unpredictable.
It's important for us to have a sense that that process of making those CAR T cells is going to be successful. I need to see as high of a number as they can possibly achieve. The more cells, the better.
What's the culture look like numbers-wise? This is today's?
Yeah, this is today.
Yeah, it dropped.
So you're reading out about 13%, which isn't great.
The number of those cells is lower than I would have hoped for. You know, so he may or may not meet target dose. You know, but I mean, again, none of this is certain until we see the final product next week, so. Yeah, we really can't wait before we treat him. He clearly has progressive leukemia.
It's still early. It's going to be low.
Yeah. I mean, there's something there. The number of CAR T cells that I have is not enough. Dealing with these sorts of trials, it's a roller coaster, right?